I'm not gonna lie, you know, decent equipment for streaming or recording videos or even taking video calls from home can get really expensive. And most professionals will agree that you really need three key elements to produce nice results. First, and probably the most important, is really having great audio capture. Now the next thing is having the right lighting, and good lighting can compensate even for a bad camera. And that leads to the third element, the camera itself. You know, you can invest thousands of dollars getting everything right, but what if you're on a super tight budget? What if you had just $25 to spend for audio, lighting, and the camera? Could that work? Let's find out. So as the webcam supplies started to normalize a year or so into the pandemic, more and more options started to surface with an integrated LED ring light. Of course, they also have onboard audio and a camera. After all, they're all webcams. So to test whether this was even possible, I headed over to Amazon. Then I looked for a cheap camera with a ring light built in and as close to a perfect score of 5 stars as possible. And this could be the one. It's the Tawinki. Am I saying that right? The Tawinki? It's a 1080p webcam, HD webcam with ring light, privacy cover, built-in microphone, plug and play for USB, PC, desktop, laptop, computer. Great for conferencing, recording, gaming, Zoom meeting, Skype, Teams camera. And it's a pretty awesome name and it sounds like it can do it all, but can it? And really to help it out, there are free tools that you can do to improve how it sounds just in case the microphone that's built in isn't amazing. So why don't we hear and see exactly what we're dealing with. So this is the Tawinki full HD camera with ring light. The light is set to the third position. You can see there's a little bit of lens distortion. It's not terrible, but there's a little lens distortion on the side that's pointed down a little tiny bit, which is kind of why the windows in the background look like they do. The one thing though that I want to point out, which is kind of unbearable actually, I would say, is the microphone in this camera. So I've got two different noise suppression filters on. I'm using both the Speaks filter, which is an OBS, and I'm using also the RN Noise filter. So it's got a bit more pull on the CPU, having to filter that out. I've turned both of them off, and it kind of sounds like transistor radio technology from the 1930s. If you've ever watched any old World War II footage, that's kind of what the camera's microphone sounds like that's built in. So for the sake of everyone, I'm gonna go ahead and turn noise suppression back on. And that's what it looks like with the microphone re-enabled with noise suppression. So it does need a little bit of help on the software side, or actually a lot of help. Okay, so you just saw this camera is okay from the video standpoint, but wow, is the audio terrible. Luckily, there are some free software tools with OBS and noise suppression filters that you can use to help it out. Now, the question is, for $25, would I recommend this camera? No. No, I would not recommend this camera. Save your money. You know, for a webcam with a 78 degree field of view, I'd recommend the Logitech C922 Pro for about $75 typically. Check out this video to see it alongside other Logitech cameras. And if you want something with a wide angle lens, I still stand behind my Mikose recommendation for around $85, and I still use it every day. So check out this video on that camera. And of course, that also means that you'll need a USB microphone, at least a ring light as well. So expect to spend around $150 at the bare minimum. And yes, that's 6 times more than the cost of this particular camera. And it's gonna be worth it. Hopefully this saves you a bit of pain with some trial and error. And if you liked this video or wanna see more gadgets and general tech tips, be sure to subscribe to the channel. And as always, thank you so much for watching.